Welcome to Datadog 101. I'm Matt Williams, and I'm one of the evangelists here at Datadog. Datadog 101 is a series of videos that get you up and running with the product. To navigate around the application, you can use the sidebar menu. The responsive sidebar menu has three main states that you can toggle: expanded, minimized, and hidden. Use the icons at the top left to switch between them. When you first log into the platform, you usually start at the event stream. The event stream is perfect for getting a quick look at what's been going on recently in your environment. You can always come back to the event stream to see the most recent updates to your environment. The event stream is split up into four main sections. At the top is the search box and the time period selection. Below that, to the left, is a list of data sources. To the right is the aggregation view. And then the central section is the actual event stream. Even if the last dozen events are alerts, a quick glance at the aggregation view at the top lets you know what's been trending recently. Change the time period, and you get an aggregate for a different time span. Below the event view on the sidebar is dashboards. When you first come to this section, you can see all the dashboards your colleagues create, as well as dashboards that are enabled when you install the corresponding integration. Dashboards that are more important for you can be starred to keep them on the top of your list. The starred dashboards also appear on your dashboards menu. When you're ready to create your own dashboards, click New Dashboard. There are two types of dashboards available. There are screen boards and there are time boards. Time boards are ideal for troubleshooting and correlation. Screen boards are excellent general status boards that you might display on a TV monitor. Screen boards are perfect for viewing the overall health and status of a service or entire infrastructure. You can customize your screen boards with widgets like graphs, query values, images, and more. Conditionally format widgets to create a visual cue for healthy and unhealthy thresholds. When you identify something of concern on a screen board, move to a time board for triage investigation. Time boards can be easily created ahead of time or ad hoc to troubleshoot a particular issue. Time board graphs are in sync and help with diagnostics by allowing you to pinpoint what's happening across metrics and services at the same time. The third video will go into much more detail about how to create both types of dashboards. So let's move on to the host map. The host map is an amazing visualization that gives you a higher level view of your infrastructure. Each of these hexagons represents a host, and you can group and filter these hosts however you want. Then you can modify their appearance based on any metric. You can use one metric to affect the color of each host and another to influence the size. Then zoom in and out to see all of your hosts or just a small group that are most interesting right now. As you find specific hosts that require more analysis, you can inspect their details. Up to six integrations are shown in the hexagon once you get zoomed in enough, and more are shown below in the detail pane. Click on any integration and see a mini dashboard below. Want to see more? Click on the dashboard link and analyze away. Once you find a host map that works well for your needs, save it, and you can see it in the list every time you visit. There's much more that you can do with the host map, and you should refer to this article in the blog or the docs for more information. If you want to get the details of a specific host, then the infrastructure list may be a quicker path. Filter down the host by name, integration, or any other tag, and then click on the inspect link to get more detail. The next section in the menu is the monitors. Monitors are where you go to check on existing monitors and create new ones. Monitors can also be thought of as alerts and notifications, though monitor is a more appropriate term since it's not just about getting your attention when something goes wrong. Since monitors are such a critical section, I'll be dedicating an entire video to the topic coming up. So for now, let's move on to the next section, metrics. The Metrics Explorer lets you identify metrics at a glance without creating a full dashboard. The Metrics Summary is a great place to see which metrics are available to you in your environment. The summary view shows you all the metrics available listed alphabetically. Filter the metrics by typing in the text box at the top. When you click on any metric, you get a summary of the metric, including which hosts are reporting that metric, a list of the metrics tags, and general information about the metric. Now you might notice that the section labeled metadata is editable. You can update the description, the unit, and the metric type. When you do, the edited information is viewable by anyone in your organization. Org-specific details are useful to help newer coworkers understand the value of individual metrics in your environment. The last of the feature icons includes integrations, API keys, agent installation, and embeds. The integrations page is where you go to turn on and configure any of the integrations. You can filter them down or just scroll to find what you need. The ones you're currently using appear first. When you click on any of the integration tiles, you see two or three tabs. First is the overview of the integration. If there are any instructions that you need to install the integration, you can find them on the configuration tab. Finally, most of the integrations have a metrics tab that lists out all the metrics available for that integration. Up here at the top, I can switch to APIs. Here I can see a list of API keys and application keys that are currently in use in my organization. Finally, you can see a list of event emails. These are email addresses that you can use to submit events to Datadog. For more details on using these, refer to this page in the documentation. Next is the agent installation page. Here you can find all the instructions for installing the various agents in your environment. The last part of this section is the embeds. Later on, when we cover dashboards, you'll see that we can embed any dashboard graph in any other web page using iframes. Anytime you create an embed, it's listed here. The last few icons in this menu are the help page with easy access to the docs and support resources, the team page where you can see who's on your team and add other people to the team, and then your settings page. If you're a member of multiple organizations, you can see them listed here and be able to switch to any one of them. And that's a brief overview of everything in the product. In the next video, we're going to cover getting data into the system using the agents, the API, custom integrations, and more. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.